Good morning.
Standing on the Northern Lights home. Good morning. How are you doing? We have seen some of the best skaters in the world out on the ice this morning. We saw that Hamar's getting ready for their competition tomorrow night in free skate. We've got some of the best men in the world. Who should we be watching out there right now?
We have two of the five studs out there right now with Elvis Stoiko and world champion Kurt Browning. Great rivalry between these two skaters. Elvis just won the Canadian Championships in Kurt's hometown, so there might be a little bit of competitive bad blood there. They're best of friends, but Kurt just ended his long program run through, and Elvis is next. This is one of the great things about these practice orders is that they go in alphabetical order, so Kurt Browning always skates before Elvis Stoiko.
Boy, would I hate to be competing. I'd be dead last.
Now, so what's great about this is you see all the best guys, and you get to see them head-to-head. Everybody has all these... they're always wondering who's going to be good, and everybody has their own opinion on who's going to win. But when you don't really know until you see them together on the same ice, and it's really competitive, these practice sessions.
Technically, if Elvis pulls off what he wants to, where would that leave him in the field?
Well, technically, he'd blow the rest of the field away. Technically,
if he does a quad.
But there's all sorts of different things you have to look at in figure skating. He's got a quad. He's done three or four of them this morning. He's an incredible technician, a great athlete.
Are we going to see one here in the practice session?
He'll open big. He always opens big. He is probably the most, I'd say, conditioned athlete in the entire field. First jump will be triple Lutz right here.
All right. That looks like a beauty to me. How about to you?
Well, I think Elvis would take that one any day of the week.
Kurt dropped over here earlier this morning, and he seemed very relaxed.
Kurt's great. He's been really loose in practice. Every time he's seen me on the side, he's always making jokes and eye contact. So normally if you're in the zone, you don't acknowledge anybody in the building. But Kurt and Elvis both have been really loose in practice.
Let's talk about the American skaters we're going to be watching.
Here's a triple axel right here.
Okay. Pretty.
Triple toe combination. Elvis is technically strong.
He's hot. Let's talk about Brian Boitano, who, of course, brought home a gold medal, and Scott Davis, who beat him in the U.S. Championships. How do you expect them to do?
Brian Boitano, after the national championships, I thought he might be a little tense coming in here, but I think what he said at the Nationals is true. He said he was more nervous at the Nationals than he's ever been anywhere in his life, and since he's been here, he's been really loose as well. He's been skating really, really
great. But he revamped his whole program. That's sort of unprecedented this close to the Olympics to go back and blow it up and sort of start all over again.
Yes and no. You need the second triple axel when you're competing against this group of guys, and he hadn't landed it all year in competition, so he had to find a way to get the second triple axel in the program so he wasn't too tired to land it.
We have some tape of Scott Davis practicing earlier this morning. How does he look to you?
Scott's been getting a little bit better with each practice. You know, I think he was a little nervous. It's the first time he's ever practice with Brian Boitano, and Brian's got a lot of experience, and he can make sure that you know that he's skating well. But Scott is gonna, you know, he's stronger every single day. He's the quickest competitor in the entire competition, and he's watching this practice now. He is so quick and tight in the spins on the ice and in the air in his jumps. He just snaps the rotation. He's incredibly, the reflex action is just awesome.
Brian Boitano has talked very quickly in closing about how everybody's not so thrilled to have him back on the ice competing. Maybe it's our turn. Is that real? Or?
I think so. I think, you know, a lot of the guys look at Brian. He's had his time, and he's won his gold medal, and now he's here to, you know, be back. And he's every competitor's nightmare. He's consistent, and you know he's never going to miss a jump. So that's not what you want to have in the competition when you're competing for gold medal.
Thanks so much for dropping by. I know you've got a lot to do between now and Thursday night. Go get some sleep.
Yeah, that's it.
All right, thanks a lot, Scott Hamilton. Let's go back now.
It is very quiet at the Northern Lights Hall in Hamar this evening. But last night, the 1988 gold medalists Yekaterina Gordieva and Sergei Grinkov returned to Olympic competition with a performance that highlighted the evening. Russian pair is atop the leaderboard after the technical program. Canada's Isabelle Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler, the 1993 world champions, presented an error-free program and kept alive their hopes of an Olympic gold medal. They're currently in third place. The most intriguing story of the night came from the other Russian pair, Natalia Mishkichanok and Artur Dmitriev. After a frightening fall in the morning practice, the Albertville gold medalists skated a nearly flawless program. Today, their coach Tamara Moskvina talked about last night.
I even was surprised because the practice was so bad that I couldn't get rid of the thoughts, what will happen in the evening. But then I made all these hypnotizing maneuvers, and Natalia did proper preparation, and still when they did program, I was really happy that I could even stop myself from jumping when she did this double axel.
As the pair ended the program with their trademark, Natasha's spin, Artur added one more element for the audience and his coach.
When he did it, I like wanted to kill him, because it happened many times before. And I told him, skate till the very end. Don't just invent something during the program.
Practice for the ice dancers underway here at the Northern Lights Hall and the American champions, Elizabeth Punselin and her husband Jared Swallow, on the Olympic ice for the first time. Scott and I have come to what they call the kiss and cry area. This is where the competitors come to wait for their marks, and they wave and either kiss and cry or whatever. Scott, there was some thought that last night Mishki Charnock and Dmitriev sat here and didn't get the marks that they'd earned from the judges.
Well, I can see how people could say that or would say that. For Mishki Charnock and Dmitriev, they had a very passionate, dramatic, exciting performance. They've been struggling all week in practice, and a lot of people consider them the underdogs coming in, so I can see a little push for them. But they did have some problems in their technical program. The lift was very slow, and it looked a little scary going up. I thought he might even drop her again. And their pair combination spin had a couple bobbles in it. It wasn't squeaky clean. For Gordiev and Grinkov, they also had a small problem in the side-by-side pair combination spin, but their twist was incredible and their lift was flawless. I really think the judges did the right thing putting them first.
You've been watching the men practice for about a week now. Give us a sense of how they're doing.
The men are incredible watching practice, because it's a can you top this session. And today, I don't think anybody can top what we saw from Elvis Stoiko. He did a combination I've never seen before, a quadruple toe loop, triple toe loop combination that's 7 revolutions in less than 3 seconds. He did it in his long program run through, which means we'll probably see it in the competition. This is an incredible feat. I don't think anybody in the world could even begin to try this combination. He's an incredible athlete, and it's going to be fun to see if he does in the competition.
Well, if he lands that, he's going to get huge.